Yes, yes, you are here. Welcome to I Am Not the Elite, where we know that the elite who seem to be controlling everything, out in the forefront of all things, are the ones in the ancient tablets that say are going to be fooled. And those that follow them will be fooled right along with them. We are in the midst of a rainstorm here in the Florida, Georgia border. It is over 90 degrees still. Temperature has not dropped, and it is something else. Something else today also is that we have to give our condolences to all that stuff that's going on down there in Broward County in Miami, Florida. Yes, there was a building that collapsed halfway. I mean, half the building just collapsed. And as we speak right now, they are still in quasi-rescue mode, trying to find as many people as they can. And our hearts and our minds and our souls and our prayers and meditations, they go out to them as we hope they find many more people alive. I believe they found about 100 alive, and still 150 are still missing. And, you know, they said there's about 3 stories worth of debris that they have to fight through, and they're also tunneling underneath a nearby park to go underneath the debris to see if they can find other people that are still alive. What a mess. What a mess over there. Now, what may have caused something like this? This disaster is unmitigated. We here in the United States just don't have buildings falling apart, splitting with people inside them. I mean, living inside them. It appeared to be at least a 7, 8, 9 story building. And you probably take a look at it on your local news and, you know, get a good thing about it. But what would cause something like this is the question. So a lot of the things that the elite are not talking about on the news channels is that there was, about a month ago, something like a 5 or 6 megahertz earthquake in the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Florida. And you know that's the worst thing that Florida needs is earthquakes. So there have been earthquakes over there off the coast of Florida, not too far away from Miami. I think it may have been 30, 40 miles out. And I think it was a deep one. MB33 has reported on that, about the earthquakes that are happening. And it's really something that we really need to pay attention to. Something like that happened on the Gulf side, we would see sinkholes opening up left and right without any warning. So Florida, that's one thing that we don't need, and that could have been a contribution to that. The other thing is that what they are not really talking about on the news is that the United States military has detonated a very powerful bomb off the shores of Florida as well. Now, you also know that what happened is that not too far away from Mar-a-Lago in that area, there's been a lot of different types of planes, military planes, circling the area, paying attention to submarines, so-called possible submarine incursions from Russia, right? Not exactly sure if it's from China, but from Russia. And just here over the past 5 days, they have detonated a very serious bomb, saying it is practice, in the not too far from the vicinity of the area where the submarine or whatever they were tracking seems to have been located. I tell you that the devastation of that bomb that went off, when you look it up, I would not want to be part of that or in the vicinity of that bomb when it went off. That was a powerful one. So we have a few things that are going on over there. Also, this building was going through a 30-year inspection, I believe. Had some outstanding inspections that were going on it. And it seems that, you know, as they were doing the inspections, there was a list of things that needed to be fixed with that building. But again, plenty of buildings around have, you know, tons of stuff that needs to be fixed. I mean, we got slumlords everywhere. This doesn't look like a slumlord building. There's a lot of different things that are happening, but you know, again, buildings in the United States do not make a habit of just falling apart, especially if there's no earthquake activity. And here, there was some earthquake activity about a month ago. I believe it was last month, maybe the month before. It was in the vicinity of a 5 or 6 mega earthquake. So, and as you know, there's tremors that go along with that, and they go in sequence. So if you keep up with that, listen to MB333, and you get more information on that one. But yeah, a lot of crazy things going on. We got Kamala Harris. All of a sudden, after Trump is going to be making his visit next Monday, I believe, with the governor, Kamala Harris is coming back into the United States after coming from Guatemala and some of those Central American countries. And she is going to be visiting the border, I believe, today, on the day of this broadcast. She's going to be looking at the border and seeing all kinds of stuff. So her main thing is the reason why she hasn't been going to the border was that she was outside of the country trying to determine as to why people are leaving the countries that they're leaving. You know, why are you leaving, you know, places like Guatemala, Honduras, El Salvador, Nicaragua, Panama, you know, why are you leaving, you know, all these different Central American countries? So she's out there, as she says, trying to get a hold on to that while all of these children are coming across the border unaccompanied. Unaccompanied. This is a disaster at the border, far worse than anything that we've seen in quite some time. And, you know, some say that that should have been the first place you should have went. In terms of trying to figure out what's happening, what's going on with the United States. Problem is that this is going to have an impact on quote-unquote minority neighborhoods and areas, because where do you think these people are going to be going? You know, what jobs do you think they're going to be taking? We're just now coming out of COVID, and, you know, a lot of states are now really getting out of the COVID mentality. And, you know, as things open up, you know, they're still looking for people to get jobs. And as they have all these jobs being held up right now because of the unemployment stuff, meaning they're getting more unemployment than they would get working. This stuff doesn't actually end until maybe July, August, September. You know, the unemployment situation might be going back to normal. Then we'll see exactly what happens to the workforce. But it seems as though that, you know, the immigration stuff isn't really a big bother to a lot of these political leaders, except for the border states who have to actually really deal with these things. Now, Texas was sending their people down there to help deal with the border, and Homeland Security got really pissed off, saying that you're involving yourself in international affairs and that the borders of the country is federal responsibility and not state responsibility. Well, that's very interesting, because the states are the ones that have to deal with it as these people come across the border themselves. So we got a lot of things that are going on. We have a lot of stuff going on in what you would call indigenous country. A lot of things happening in that. And what is indigenous company? Well, I'm going to have another broadcast to try to get you up to speed about what indigenous country is. It's different from the Black Americans, African Americans. It's different from the Mexicans. It's different from Native Americans. It's different from, you know, any of the Latinos or Hispanic type populations. It's different from the white population. You know, the indigenous population is something, you know, not on the rise, but has always been here. It's just now that they're just now beginning to start to take care of themselves. But there's a whole host of things that are going on amongst the indigenous people themselves. And, you know, it's getting very interesting as the certain states start to rise, as what they call the Amerikusa starts to come into play, as the Akamaks and a lot of these other people, Creeks or the Muscogee and all these other indigenous Mohawks and Mohicans and all these other different things, even up east, out west, all over the country, all over North America, tend to rise. And it comes on the heels of all that stuff that's happening over there in Canada. Now, Canada, as you may not know, has a large Native American and indigenous population that's actually indigenous to the country. That's what you would call original indigenous American Indians. And they're finding remains left and right, hundreds, you know, and you know, even thousands of remains of children that they have taken out of their indigenous places and homes, and then forced them to go into these Catholic schools. They're finding remains in a lot of these yards and stuff like that as they begin to start digging things up and trying to do reclamation, et cetera, et cetera. And they're finding a lot of bodies where a lot of these kids were killed. So the Catholic Church has a lot to answer for that, along with the Doctrine of Discovery, or the Discovery Doctrine. So there's a lot of things that they have to answer to, and the state of Canada is going to answer to that too, right? Because it's not only just, you know, Native Americans, but also the Indigenous Americans that they're finding, and mixed in with all this stuff. And, you know, all these stories that they got going on here is just devastating. Devastating. So I just wanted to really keep you up to date on what's going on with that. But, you know, keep an eye on the stuff that's going on down there in southern Florida. A lot of people that are trapped underneath that rubble. It's really crazy, unbelievable, all the things that are happening. Got Kamala Harris visiting the border today. We'll see what's going on with that. The other thing that I want to really mention on this broadcast is that the inflation, the elite doesn't want you to know that, but we've been talking about the inflation now on this channel and my other channels, that the inflation is beginning to start getting out of hand. It's going up, going up, going up. The feds are not raising the interest rates. They've been having meetings for the last couple of weeks. They're not raising interest rates, and the stock market is still rallying in hopes that these inflation is only going to be temporary. But in case if it isn't temporary, just make sure that, you know, you're getting yourself in a very strong economic position, meaning that you're trying to pay up every single bill that you have, that you're getting real property, you're paying off your vehicles, making sure that no matter what goes on with the banking system, that you're going to be secure in your own right. Don't depend on anybody, including the banking system, the Federal Reserve, or the United States government, to come out to help you or save you as they're spending trillions upon trillions upon trillions of dollars. So, you know, we got all the stuff that's going on around here, a lot of stuff that's happening. You got the stuff with Wuhan, right? The Republicans are, you know, having all these things. Again, all this stuff is mainly political posturing because they're getting ready for the 2022 midterm elections, which is going to be something else, as well as they're waiting for all this stuff going on with the recounts. I'll give a recount update specifically on what's going on with that in another broadcast, probably later on today. But it is very important for us to really make sure that we who are not the elite keep each other informed and make sure that we are getting that information out there that we need to make sure that we understand what's going on with the digital currency. We understand what we know what's going on with the oil markets, what's going on with the housing market, what's going on with the inflation that's going on, what's going on with all this farming issues that are happening, what's going on with all these food shortages that were happening. We have to make sure that no matter who you are, what you are, even if you're shy, don't show yourself on camera. Just have something out there, maybe a little picture in front of it. Give an update on the things that you know that's going on in your neck of the woods, because this is exactly what we need as we push forward and trying to make sure that we are okay. Well, you know, I love you. I care for you. Make sure that you are all right. And my meditations going out for each and every one of you. And as I always say, keep on rising. Keep on moving forward. Keep understanding that no matter what happens, you are going to make it. We are going to make it. And we are going to make it extremely well. So, you know, this is not the end, my friend. Great grand rising to us all. Great grand rising to us all. Great grand rising to all of those that are out there getting this work done. Take care.